How's everyone doing? I have a dream I want to talk to you guys about. This dream was a little interesting, and I think I want to discuss this dream because it was one of my end time dreams. So here it is, I'm gonna go right into it. So last night I had a dream where last night I had a dream where I was outside, right? So I was outside and I remember looking out in the sky and the moon and the stars and everything. And the first thing I noticed was the moon. I noticed there were like two moon as I'm watching all of this. And I'm like, there's two moon. There's actually two moon. And it's crazy how you're in a dream and you don't realize that you're dreaming and you think you're like, this is real, this is actually happening. So that's what I felt. I felt like I was literally watching two moons. And I was like, oh my gosh, there's two moons here. So I'm starting to report this to other people and telling them to look at the sky, look at the moon. As you can see, there's two moon. And they were like, no, we don't see two moon. And I was like, what do you mean you don't see two moon? I'm like, I'm looking at it. And I'm like, watching. There's two moon here. And they were like, no, we don't see two moon. So people started thinking that I was crazy. So as I'm watching these two moon, and it was like a average, normal looking moon. But they were bright, really, really, really bright. So as I'm watching these two moon, and I'm trying to warn everybody, let them know that I see two moon. I noticed there was this big, and I mean this huge rock was coming down and was just falling down from the sky, and one of the moon got, like, it hit one of the moon and it broke it in half. And I was like, oh my gosh, one of the moon just got hit by the big asteroid that was coming. And I was like, you guys, an asteroid is coming straight for Earth. I'm like trying to warn everybody. Nobody wanted to listen to what I was saying. And they kept saying, oh, you're delusional. You're crazy. You're seeing two moon and this and that. And we don't see any of that stuff. And then I noticed, okay, the only time I had a dream where I saw like the moon was split in half was that mystery ray dream that I had, a mystery cosmic ray dream that I had like a year ago, where the moon had split in half and no one was able to see that, but my eyes were able to see it. So it's like I'm going through the same thing all over again. So I'm watching these two moon, but it was two moon this time. So I'm watching two moon, right? And an asteroid crashed into one of them and it split it in half. And I'm watching all of this and I'm crying, I'm screaming, I'm like, oh my God, oh my gosh, can you not see this? Do you guys not see this? And people couldn't see what I saw. And I was like, there's an asteroid coming. There's an asteroid coming. It just split the moon in half. And they were like, nah. Like the people was just, you know, ignoring me. And they didn't want to heed the warning that I was warning them about upon this asteroid coming down and coming, you know, falling into the earth. So I noticed, I went up to my husband and my children and I was telling them, an asteroid is coming, look at the moon, there's two moon out there and one of them was split in half. And I know it sounded crazy, but that's what I saw. And then people thought I was crazy, and I still wanted to warn people. I still wanted to let people know there was an asteroid coming. There's an asteroid coming, and it's heading straight to Earth, straight from us. And as I said that, like, people kept thinking that I was crazy. I started noticing, like, you started seeing it very clear. This big rock of fire was coming down from the sky. Huge rock of fire was coming down from the sky. And finally, they started to believe what I was saying. But it was already too late. They didn't want to listen to me then. Then again, I don't think anyone could stop it. I don't think there was anything they could do besides get on their knees and start praying. So when you finally got to see the asteroid coming down and everything, I grabbed my family and I went inside the house. I went inside the house and I told them the asteroid is coming now. Like, you could literally see it coming down. And when I saw it coming down, everybody was pointing at it. Everybody, finally, they believed me and they started pointing at the asteroid, but it was already too late. They should have started praying and repenting or whatever, but nobody was listening. So finally, you can see it with your own eyes and everything. So people was going crazy. People was crying and screaming and everything. And my husband and I went inside the house. But before we went inside the house, what we saw was the asteroid, as it was coming down, it split in three. Like, you saw it's. I saw it split in three, like, and I'm like, and it's funny, in the spirit, I knew one was going north, the other one was going south, and the other one was going west, or, yeah, let's see, west, we're on the west side, so it was going east, so I'm looking and I'm like, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, there's three of them now. First, it was just one big old rock, and this rock was huge, you guys. It was probably the size of one of the countries in the United States, probably the size of, I would say this rock was so big, it looked like the size of Washington. And it was just coming down, but it split in three. The rock was able to split in three. As soon as it made land, like, not made land, but like, as soon as it hit the sky, like, there was like this loud noise, like pow, like it was so loud, and it hit the sky and it just broke off in three pieces. So I'm looking at it, broke off in three pieces and everything, right? And I'm like, oh my gosh, this thing just broke off in three pieces. So you're looking at all of this, right? And so I'm looking at all of this and I said, okay, this is it. Let's go and pray. I told my husband and my children, go in the house. Let's go and pray. We need to pray. So I started praying and I'm praying to God and I'm begging God and I'm asking God, please, please, Lord, please, please protect us, save us. You know, if I sin against you in any kind of way, if I did anything unpleasing to you, Father God, I just pray, Father God, that you will forgive me of all my sins and iniquity and all that stuff. And I was like, please forgive me. And all of us, we were just hovering up and just praying and asking God to forgive us. And then finally, the asteroid made land. It hit land and made impact. And all you heard was the ground shaking, like a great earthquake started shaking the ground. And then I would say a few minutes later, I don't know how long it wasn't that long, I would say maybe a minute or two, you started seeing the waves coming. A big wave was coming, a tsunami was coming. And as I'm watching this wave come, people were still outside and they started screaming and running for their life. People was just running for their lives. That's all you can do is run. But me and my family, we were inside the house and we could see everything from the window, from outside the window. And we were just, you know, praying. We were on our knees praying and asking God for mercy to spare us, if it's His will to spare us and stuff like that. But, you know, we were ready to go. I was ready to go, and I was like, this is it. I don't care how I go, whether it's death or whatever, I'm ready. I was ready. I was like, this is it. And so the impact came so fast. It rushed into us so fast, and we all died. We were all underwater. The water was ice cold, you guys. This I can remember. I'm telling you, every details I could remember from that dream. It was freezing cold. And I remember before the impact hit, it was freezing cold. It was snowing. It was cold outside. It was ice cold. It was just snow everywhere. But when the tsunami came, I felt the ice of the water. The water was just freezing cold, you guys. It was so cold. And we died, like everybody died. We all died. And as I'm underwater and everything, suffering, like trying to hold my last breath, and then I died. I watched everyone die around me. And then as I died, I heard this woman's voice, this spiritual woman's voice. I heard her voice, and she said, "It's Tanya. Wake up. Wake up. It's not your time to go yet. It's not your time. Wake up." And then I woke up. My eyes opened up. When I opened my eyes, all I could see all around me was dead bodies. Bodies floating all over, everywhere. I looked out the window. I was just... And then I'm like, am I dead? And then I was like, I'm still alive. And then I heard the voice again. I heard the lady's, the woman's voice again. This spiritual woman's voice again. I heard her, and she said, this is what she said. She said, go to the wall. And it's funny, because as I'm lying there, I look behind me, and I saw my husband. My husband was holding on to me like this. He was just holding on to me. He held on to me, and we died in each other's arms. And it's crazy. And I saw him, and I saw my body, my husband's dead body, holding on to me. And I had to, like, he was holding on so tight to me, I had to pull his hands out of my I had to, you know, pull him out of me and everything. And I watched them just sat there, floating in water. And I watched, and I saw all my kids. I saw all these dead bodies everywhere outside. There was so many dead bodies floating. They were all just floating up. And the lady said to go next to the wall. Go to the wall. And as I went to the wall, I noticed, she said again, "You're stronger than you know." She said, "Break through the wall." And I was like, break through the wall? And I was like, she wants me to break through this wall? This is like cement wall. I can't break this. Like cement. I'm not breaking through this. And I don't know. Like all of a sudden, I wanted to get out of there. So I started punching through the wall. And I noticed there was a little air up there. And then I realized, what am I doing? I can breathe underwater. I don't understand, but I knew I could breathe underwater. So all of a sudden, I'm breathing underwater. I know. This is where it gets weirder. So I'm breathing underwater, and I'm breaking through the wall and everything. And I broke. I just kept punching, and then boom! The third punch was so strong. The impact was so strong. I broke right through the wall. And for some reason, when I went in the next room where I broke through that wall, there was no water there. And all the water drained it out. And all of a sudden, all the water, like everywhere, all the water drained out. And I went up to my husband. I grabbed my husband and I took him to the next room. I grabbed him and I started, what I started doing was giving him mouth to mouth and everything. Started pumping the water out of him. I was like, "Don't you leave me. Don't you leave me. You're not going to leave me here. You're not going to leave me here. Wake up, wake up." And I kept trying to wake him up, and I'm looking at my husband's dead corpse, and I'm like, no, I'm not giving up on you. I'm not giving up on you. You're not gonna die on me. And I was just hysterical, just going crazy out of my mind. I'm not gonna lose you. I'm not gonna lose you. And finally, finally, something like the spirit, whatever it was, that woman again spoke to me, and she said, "Tell him to wake up. You can wake him up." And then I blew on his face like this smoke of air. And I said, "Wake up." And then he woke up. He opened his eyes. He looked at me, and then he woke up. The minute my husband woke up, my children started waking up too. Like, it was weird. Like, everybody started waking up. And then I noticed all the dead people that were outside lying flat under, the water had mysteriously disappeared all of a sudden. I don't know what happened to the water. But all these people, everybody started waking up. So it was weird. Everybody woke up, everybody got up, and I'm looking and I'm like, okay, everybody's up now. And this is crazy. I remembered all this dream, and all of a sudden I can't remember the rest of what happened in this dream. I guess this is where I leave off and say, this is where I can't. This is ludicrous. I can't remember the rest of the dream. I remembered everything, but all of a sudden, it just, my memory just completely left me right now. I can't remember the rest of this dream. All the dead people woke up. Everybody woke up. Like, people were all dead. All of a sudden, we all woke up. And pause one second. Wow. I really can't remember what happened after that. I woke up and everybody woke up, and all I could remember is crazy is everyone else started waking up. The dead, all the, these dead people started waking up. And wow, I've never had this happen to me before where I can't remember the rest of the dream. I guess I'm not meant to tell the rest of the story. But if I can remember the rest of this story, I guess I'll come back on here and do a part two. But for now, this is all I have. All I could remember was everyone around me woke up. The dead all woke up. And I was happy to be back with my family. We were all woken up. And I just know that this dream kind of scared the living lights out of me, because I know there was a lot more in this dream, and I saw myself doing a lot more after this dream. But one thing I can say, I do remember this one thing after I had this, when I woke up. I remember me having these abilities that I don't have, and people aren't supposed to have. I remember having these abilities, and I was doing stuff. I can't remember what I was doing. I can't even go into details because I can't remember the rest of this dream. This is crazy. Wow. I guess not everything I meant to share. Yeah. But guys, just be ready, because you don't know how much longer we have left in this world. I mean, it's getting ready to happen, you guys. And people are asleep right now. A lot of people are asleep and they don't know what's getting ready to happen. There probably is a real asteroid out there, and it's coming, and they know about it, and they don't want to tell us about it. I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen in a few weeks, a few months, a few, I don't know, we have years left. All I know is time is very short. And if you feel like you want to repent and turn away from your sins and you can't do it, ask God to help you. Because time is very short, and you need to get ready and be ready for God, because He is coming and we don't want to be sleeping. Just know that the Lord is almost here. And I know a lot of people are like dying right now, like, oh my God, when is He coming? When is He coming? Just know He's coming. We have to pray for patience. We have to pray that God would just give us strength and patience. He is coming, you guys. He is coming. And just a little bit more time. Just a little bit more time. Just hang in there. Hang in there. You made it this far. Don't give up. Don't give up, okay? I know it's hard. It's easier said than done. Just pray. Pray that the Lord will give you strength. I love you guys. God bless you. Shalom. I gotta thank you. Just wanna thank you for what you've done. Thank you for everything.